Royal Jasper Quarterly. We're asking that the children have a better future. We're asking that the elderlies be heard and the reservations be investigated. All 564 federal tribes are asking that we see whose names are on the documents for the treaties, who's neglecting our treaties, and who's signing them, because we're not getting no help. We're asking that Tracy Tulu of the Department of Justice be suspended because he denied his oath in front of the Lakota grandmothers and myself, and then pressed charges of treason for neglect of onerous fiduciary duty of trustee status concerning the 500 indigenous tribes before the grandmothers of the Great Lakota Nation.
No flash.
We're asking that anybody involved with the 564 federal recognized tribes who have neglected the treaties and neglected their oath of office and neglected the Constitution, they too also face the onerous fiduciary duty of trustee status neglect. What I'm saying is they're fired, and we want them in jail, and we want them to face their criminal charges, because this is not working for us. And we like to work better relationships with the United Nations and do away with the federal government. That's pretty much the bottom line. And so with the rest of my time, I'd like to hand it over to my, what I will now call her, my Hunka sister.
We recommend that the permanent forum members work with ECOSOC to integrate the needs of Indigenous people's governments into all UN processes, so Indigenous people's governments can hold colonial governments and their corporations accountable for violence against Indigenous peoples and our ecosystem. We recommend that you promote respect for the rule of laws of nations, which prevents the imposition of the European legal system, including the myth of discovery, on any other continent besides Europe. We recommend you promote reciprocity, so when European legal systems are imposed on non-European continents, Europe must also allow the imposition of laws from other continents on Europe. This promotes reciprocity and the reparations necessary to equip us all to meet the climate crisis. We recommend y'all build capacity through research, training, and implementation for Indigenous governments to effectively investigate, document, and prosecute corruption rings, appropriating the benefits of Indigenous natural, spiritual, cultural, economic, and political blessings. We ask the permanent forum members to study and document corruption and explore methods of promoting accountability and transparency while equipping Indigenous and customary governments to advance our own time-tested legal processes to end corruption.
Thank you very much for your...
Ma'am, just one more small thing before we close out here. Can we say a prayer for those who died behind this corruption, please?
What I intend to do, first of all, thank you, Ms. Spotted Bear, for your intervention, drawing attention to the documents that you've provided here and the seriousness of the issues that you've raised within your intervention. I'm unsure if there are representatives of the United States government present in the room this morning, and I would encourage you to follow up and have a direct dialogue with those representatives when they do arrive. With regard to your last request, what I intend to do is adjourn the meeting, and you can do so. I don't know if there is a side event scheduled for this particular room, but just be mindful of the fact that when you conclude your prayer, that I do believe I saw a nod of the head from the Secretariat that there will be a side event in this room, so I'll allow you to do so and carry on in English. I have a couple of important announcements from the Secretariat in particular. For those individuals that inscribed their names on the list who have not been able to speak, but who have also not transmitted their written statements to the Secretariat, to please do so. It's important that we have a hard copy of the intervention that